But Johnny didn't seem to notice or care for that matter. "Favorite part's always been the thigh," he continued, dragging your body a bit closer to him so that your hips were raised a bit off the ground. He pulled his head away from your thigh and a bit down on his knife again, holding it in place as his hands moved to the brown belt and the loops of his jeans. He unbuckled it and pulled it out the loops, setting it on the ground. He unbuttoned his jeans, sliding them down, seeing as how there wasn't much else to look at. Your eyes followed his hands, and then your gaze got stuck, and you found it really hard to look away.
"Yikes."
You gulped, wishing you could look away, but strangely, the majority of you wanted to stare, and the majority was winning. Your fingers curled into his fist at the thought of what was about to happen, and you subconsciously whined. His hands moved, but your gaze did not. His knife came between your legs as he sliced the edges of your underwear and removed it from your body. With the knife so close to it, you made the very strange and mildly amusing discovery that they looked awfully similar. They were approximately the same size, albeit the knife was obviously thinner, but the length was rather accurate, and what they really shared in common was the slight curve upwards. On the knife, it was more obvious, but it was definitely present in both cases. You wonder if it was a coincidence or not. You were going to be stabbed with both of them, so at least you were checking off all the boxes during this hellish trip. There was a quiet clatter as the knife was dropped to the floor, and at last, you looked up at him. He had a weird smile on his face. Not the smile itself was weird, but it was a weird smile on him. The hints of cockiness were faint, and it was a very real smile, a human one, a very normal one.
"It ain't gonna hurt you," he assumed, one of his hands running up and down your thigh.
"I find that hard to believe," you replied, gulping once more. You were nervous, yes, and scared. Obviously, this guy was a killer, a psychopath, a monster, completely deranged. And yet, you didn't yell, you didn't tell him off, you didn't kick him. Your feet were so close to his head, you could uppercut him with a heel, but you didn't. Then he leaned down with his entire torso, and he kissed you. It was soft at first, testing the waters, but it grew rougher. He grew hungrier, you mumbled, and then you kissed him back. "What was wrong with you?" There was a hand on your hip, and he tugged your waist a little closer to his.
"Breathe," he whispered.
Breaking the kiss in order to do so, you breathe in and breathe out. You breathe in and...
"Johnny,"
you breathe out, gently biting the inside of your lip. He hadn't actually done anything yet, but you could feel it pressing against your entrance. There was a bit of pressure, but it wasn't going anywhere. "Keep on breathing, darling," he reminded. And you resumed the careful breaths as he directed. Your breath hitched again when his cock slid in, and you held your breath waiting for more. When he didn't move, you exhaled and then inhaled and exhaled a little more, and your next exhale came out in a whine. He kissed you again, and you felt his teeth drag along your bottom lip. Another inch or two, and you hummed, your back arching as that slight curve you noticed was making itself known now. And in a terrible, sickening, absolutely criminally masochistic way, you definitely appreciate. In the moment of blissful realization, there was a sudden jolt of pain in two places. He shoved the rest of his cock length into you, and his teeth pinched your bottom lip, causing a metallic taste to bubble up in your mouth. You yelped at the dual pain, and your arms flinched as a barbed wire dug into your skin once more.
Great. Pain in three places.
Johnny held the kiss a while longer, and he didn't move his hips until he pulled his mouth away from yours. There was a minuscule amount of blood on the outside of his bottom lip, but he was quick to lick it off. You didn't taste your own blood anymore, and you assumed that your lip had stopped bleeding. He sat up once more, both of his hands on either of your hips now, and he looked down at where you two were connected.
"Took you just fine, told you,"
he teased, his thumb accidentally pressing into the wound on your side as he squeezed your hips and pulled out. You winced, but Johnny either didn't realize or didn't care about the placement, and he slammed back into you, his head leaning back as he let out a drawn-out chuckle.
"Johnny! Johnny, your hand is... Oh, fuck! Holy!"
You huffled, blowing out an exhale through an O that your lips formed. He grunted as he repeated the action and actually moved his thumb down a bit, no longer irritating the stab wound. The motions were repetitive, but you weren't complaining, since that meant the pleasure kept coming back. The sun was starting to set outside of the shed, and you could see the sky behind Johnny turn to hues of blue and pink. It was strangely romantic, aside from the blood on his clothes and your skin. After a few more thrusts, he paused, panting.
"Need more? Where you want it?"
"Just my leg. I don't care," you hummed, closing your eyes as you heard him pick up the knife. There was a slight pinch on your left leg, but it actually didn't really hurt at all that much. His mouth covered up the cut as he sucked and resumed his motions. Your body was covered in nicks. What difference would a few more injuries make? At least for now, you didn't particularly care. The feeling of him inside of you was nothing short of addicting, and you assumed you got an extra surge of pleasure from tasting you. Whatever kept him going, you suppose. Every time his cock hit a wall on your insides, you were left with no choice but to moan.
and those sounds were increasing in volume. A hand clasped over your mouth, but his fucking didn't stop. Even a voice called from outside.
Johnny, time for supper.
The cannibal rolled his eyes and huffed. Frustrated with the interruption, he still refused to let up as he responded.
Give me a bit, would you? I'm busy,
he yelled back. He gripped your waist even tighter, and while he kept the same speed, his thrust grew more aggressive, almost violent. The increase in power forced more noises out of you. And Johnny growled, pressing his palm harder against your face.
Well, hurry up, we ain't waiting for you,
the man yelled back, sounding irritated. But footsteps could be heard receding as he left. Johnny waited a moment longer before his hand left your mouth, and you desperately panted between cruel mixtures of yelps and moans, your legs starting to tremble as the pleasure was rising higher, getting closer and closer to breaking.
Keeping it going, come on, damn it, take it,
he yelled, moving your hips for you as he shoved you down onto him. Yet his own thrust didn't let up. You knew there would be some form of bruising inside and out, but you were loving it all the same.
Johnny,
you cried out, your nails digging trenches into your palms as your body tensed up and your head pressed against the hard floor of the shed. And two more slams of his cock, you were completely done for, your body shuddering as you came, exhausted half-assed moans being mumbled out. Johnny wasn't quite done yet, and it took him a few more minutes of thrust and your overstimulated pleas for him to finish, and he didn't bother with safeguards as he came inside of you, making sure to wedge himself in you as deep as possible when he did. He held you in that position for a good 10 seconds before he dropped your hips to the floor and pulled out, panting only a half as heavily as you. He was sweating more than you, but the only place he noticed it was his forehead as he wiped it off with the fabric that was once your tube top. He then dropped to the floor, pulled his pants up, and put on his belt. You blinked, confused, and also just a bit brain dead from the sex. Johnny stood up, dipping his head and looking back towards the house. Don't go nowhere, I'll be back. Gramps will be pissed if I miss supper. And without giving any more explanation, he left you in the shed, not even giving you so much as a tarp to cover up with, not even bothering to take the barbed wire off your wrist. His knife was laying there, and you could definitely grab it in case of an emergency, but it didn't take away from your confusion. Sure, he was a cannibal, but this was Texas. Whatever happened to Southern hospitality?
Finally, Johnny, took you a damn millennia,
Sissy scolded, twirling around a fork with a cube of grilled meat on it.
I told you that I'd come, I came. Just had to handle some,
Johnny replied as he sat at the table. Bubba was arranging the cubes of meat on his plate into a line, rocking back and forth as he did so. Johnny felt a bit bad for making him wait to eat, but the rest were just being dramatic.
Damn girl ain't nowhere to be found, Johnny. The hell were you doing mucking around out back for? Grandpa ain't happy about the escapee,
Nubbis grumbled, leaning towards Johnny, some mix of suspicion and irritation in his gaze.
I told you I was handling something. I ain't just mucking around. I'll find her tonight,
Johnny replied, taking a bite of his food. Though he didn't show it, the meat was just barely enjoyable. He wasn't sure he'd be able to enjoy most meat anymore, not after what he'd tasted. He didn't even know what the hell he was going to do with her, but he couldn't kill her. Killing her meant that he'd only get to taste her one more time, and that was not enough for him.
You best. What you sweating so much for?
Numbers inquired. Stuffing his face full of meat, Johnny held back the urge to scowl. How he could eat something so distinguishedly average was beyond him, but it was just one more reason he couldn't let her be killed. He couldn't risk the others getting to taste her. She was his to taste and his alone. They wouldn't admire the taste like he did. They wouldn't take the time to enjoy it like he did. Johnny was the only one who could appreciate the way she deserved.
You just gonna stare or you gonna answer me?
What's the sweat from? Nubbins repeated, frowning. Johnny sighed, swallowing the meat.
Texas heat.